We're back. Radar Live number 5. So the first thing we're going to talk about on the map is the crucifixion of Michael Jackson. Now, I know there's been this entire upheaval about Michael Jackson. Did he do it? So he was proven innocent multiple times years ago. And people are still trying to like dig up shit. I'm going to just say this. As a dancer, Wade Robson, you're a has-been. I feel like maybe you're doing this to get some money, you kind of slacking, you're trying to get your name back out there, but now instead of being known as like, oh, he used to be a really dope choreographer, nobody's seen him in a while, this is why we haven't seen you, you're trying to finagle money out of the Michael Jackson estate, like, and Harpo, so disappointing. It's really like crucifixion. So then Drake decided to take the song that he had with Michael Jackson featured in it out of his show, Don't Matter to Me. What if you don't get your ass back in a wheelchair somewhere? Really? You like, no integrity. Like, people just have no integrity at all. Meanwhile, Harvey Weinstein, y'all not boycotting Harvey Weinstein movies or shows that he produced or shit that his company was backing. You were actually on the bandwagon for not putting his wife in the same box as him, and people were wearing her dresses to the award shows, like, I still stand behind her type shit. Like, really? Then this dude named Dozell, who is a producer, he's produced like hundreds and hundreds of tracks. He's good at what he does, but he worked with Michael Jackson a while ago. And he's put out an interview on Page Six talking about how he thought that everything that was being said was true. And when he worked with Michael Jackson, he was strange. And he talked to Michael Jackson's dad, Joe Jackson, and he told him about how he made Michael Jackson dance better or dance faster by putting him on a hot stove. And that Michael Jackson was starting to regret what he looked like after all the surgery because he was starting to look like his dad. Just a bunch of like off the wall shit. I just think it's real funny that once Michael Jackson's dead, now everybody trying to cash in, which is what people do, but it's like, really? Really? Anywho, I don't know how you guys feel about that, but that's my take on it. All right, so the next thing we got on the map, France. So we flying high. Je m'appelle Jace, et toi? No? So something beat. France is the first country to not force, but enforce, which I guess is still forcing, all its supermarkets, grocery stores. I think it's if it's like 4,000 square feet or bigger, something like that. I could be misquoting that. But they're making all the stores give all the old food to the needy, the homeless, homeless shelters. Like, because a lot of grocery stores, there's a rule that you can't do it. Restaurants and the shit they will do to the old food, which is like, they say it's because if something happens to people who eat it, they can sue. But I think it's a lot of it is just being an asshole. They'll pour bleach on the food. Like, all you have to do is dump it out. Really? So France is the first country in on the globe, this blue ball that we call Earth, to enforce this rule. So any supermarket that's over like 4,000 square feet has to give its food to the needy. Supermarkets that are already built have to sign up, and then any supermarket that's being built has to sign up. It's needed. They need to bring that shit to Chicago, America. Because, you know, like, at least give it to homeless shelters and pantries. I'm just saying. It's a waste. We waste like $1.5 billion in food yearly. Come on, people. So, yeah. I thought that shit was funny as hell. Alright, so the next story that we got on the map, we're gonna take it back to Bonnie and Clyde days, we're gonna take it back to Crazy in Love, we're gonna take it back to The Blueprint, what? Jay-Z, Queen B, give it a moment, give it a, just soak it up. They are being honored at the 2019 GLAAD Awards, the 30th annual GLAAD Awards. If you don't know what the GLAAD Awards is, it is a organization that is sponsored predominantly by the affiliates behind gay rights. I can't remember off the top of my head what exactly the acronym stands for, but it's gonna be right here. If you just watch my banner white hands. Jay-Z, Beyonce are being honored. I was gonna say sponsored. Wow. Jay-Z and Beyonce are being honored at the 30th annual GLAAD Awards for the Media Award. Beyonce has obviously been like a beacon of light for the gay community. She does a lot of stuff on the side. She gives a lot, most of her, you know, not most of her fans, but come on, like, it's Beyonce. And then Jay-Z, low-key, actually is a big spokesperson for like gay rights activism. Jay-Z was honored last year. He was honored because he has a song called Smile that his mom used as her coming out song, because his mom is a lesbian. But that was the song that really like put it on the map, whatever, and she was given an award last year. So now this year, both of them are being honored together, which is, it's pretty dope. Speaking of Jay-Z, Jay-Z is being inducted into the Library of Congress's National Recording Registry. Yes, the National Recording Registry. Jay-Z's album, The Blueprint, the first one. Oh, H to the O-V. His album is being inducted into the Library of Congress. Like, I'm gonna say this about Jay-Z. People be sleep on him. There was a lot of, when Jay-Z and Beyonce first started On the Run tour, people was kind of saying like, why is she on tour with him? And why would she go back on tour with him again? He was bad for sales and da-da-da-da, like really shitting on him. Like, bring Beyonce back out. I'm like, hold on. Wait a minute. Give a legend their credit. Jay-Z is a fucking mastermind. Man. The conglomeration of the two of them coming together, like really, Jay-Z being with Beyonce helped cross her into a different genre and vice versa. Like, give this man his credit. Don't forget, she's with him for a reason. People forget that part. Anywho, they are being honored, 30th Annual GLAAD Awards for the Media Award. Jay-Z is, his album Blueprint is being inducted into the Library of Congress's National Recording Registry. So, clap it up, clap it up, clap it up. I got pissed like a racehorse, y'all, but I always want to pause. So the next thing we got up on the map is Nelly. Oh, no matter what I do, all I think about is you. When I think of Nelly, that's the first song that comes to my head. But Nelly, TLC, oh, yeah. And I'm missing somebody. Flo Rida. Do not act like you don't fuck with Flo Rida. Low. Don't stunt. You know after a couple drinks, your ass be in the middle of the flow line. Ugly as fuck. So Nelly, TLC, Flo Rida are going on tour, 2019 tour. It's gonna be tickets sold by Live Nation Production. This light is really bright in my fucking eyes. They got 21 dates they're gonna be going on. It's gonna go over North America and Canada. And tickets gonna sell March 5th. No. 15th. Tickets are going to sell March 15th. So, if you're a fan, I'm a fan. I fuck around and be there. If you're a fan, turn up, go out, and bam, go check them out. The next story. Some of you might not give up, but I happen to like these people. It is what it is. I think my hand was cut out the shot. I can't see my ankles right now. But, Rob Kardashian and Blac Chyna have reached a settlement over the custody of their daughter, Dream Kardashian. I can't say what I think about the name, because it's a baby. They reached the settlement in the custody battle for the little girl, which I think is great. You guys got together, maybe y'all really like each other, but on some famous shit, and then you had a kid, and then the kid now is suffering some shit. Like, bitch, the kid don't give a fuck about being famous, but you put the kid in the middle of some shit. It's kind of petty. But I always felt kind of like Blac Chyna kind of liked him. It's always that one you don't really expect that is like, And I felt like that was her, and vice versa. And I think that's some of the reasons why Kardashian started really not wanting to fuck with Blac Chyna, because they knew, my son really like you, and we don't really fuck with you. She wasn't polished enough for them. You know what I'm saying? So, and low key, they wanted the same. One just got a little more money. That's it, that's all. Like, Kris Jenner, you watched my first video, I talked about Kris Jenner. If that bitch gave a class on how to make it and break it, if I had to sell dick and ass to be in that, I'm getting tickets. Because when I tell you that lady, yes, that bitch is Dr. Evil. In a good way. But she is pure fucking genius. When I tell you milking something, baby, cows everywhere. Just moo. Anywho, so Blac Chyna, Rob Kardashian, getting back together. And I think this is good, people. Sometimes you gotta root for love. And this needs to be part two of a reality show with them. Don't stunt, you know you watched Robin Chyna. You know you did. Like, they had a good show, good chemistry, that whole shebang. So please bring Bad Girls Club back. Like, do we need to start a petition? Like, do you need a certain amount of signatures? What do you need from us, John Q, Jane Q Public? I just want to know, for my sanity, what it is that we can do for you WeTV, Lifetime, Oxygen, MTV, BET. Somebody bring back BGC. IJS. Naomi Osaka. So back, I think it was last year, Naomi Osaka won as the won the U.S. Open against Serena Williams, and she became this like big superstar. Now she didn't get her real skyrocket that she should have from winning that U.S. Open, and why? Because Serena Williams still overshadowed the moment. I think it was the incident about her and the coach getting into it, and then her temper and her attitude. Then it was this whole thing about like, if men do this, then it's a slap on the wrist, but woman does it and I'm getting points deducted. Naomi Osaka won by default, kinda. Not necessarily by default, but Serena felt like judges were penalizing her for stupid shit, which was making them take points from her because they were really trying to either stick it to her or have Osaka win. And eventually, what ended up happening was Osaka won, not that she wasn't good, but particularly because of the point system. It was just weird to me. Like, moving forward, Osaka is being sued by her former coach. And get this shit, he is suing her for 20% of everything she earned in her career for the rest of her life. Where the fuck you get that contract at? And if you can sue her under those specific terms, he has to feel like that's plausible because it's contractual. And if that's contractual, that means it was in the contract. If you signed a contract with this man that guaranteed he get 20% of everything you earn for the rest of your life, I'm trying to figure out, Mitch, is he the devil? And you didn't know how to play tennis ever in your life? I just need to know the backstory to explain how he can say, I'm suing you for 20% of not what you earned last year for the rest of her life. This bitch like 20. Bitch, you better kill yourself tomorrow. I'm joking. Oh my God, that was so distasteful. But no, like, that is insane to me. For the rest of her life, I just don't understand that. I need to get more details about that story. I'm trying to figure out how he got that number. Because when you carry the two plus this many, you know, he was like, until the end of time, like, crazy. So, the next story we got, Kevin Tushihara. I feel like he's Japanese, but he is the CEO of Warner Brothers, and he just had to step down amidst a sex scandal, misconduct, allegations, scandal. Fuck y'all. You know what I'm saying? He just had to step down amidst some sexual allegation scandal. So apparently what he was doing was he ran like everything that Warner Brothers owned. Then on top of that, they started a global kids network and family entertainment system. Not system, but like a channel. And he was promising people acting roles and parts in new shows that were going to be coming up and new shows that were being revamped. Promising these people roles in exchange for sex. I don't know who tapped what to find out this information, what wire was put where, but I thought it was funny that... So with all the sexual allegation scandals that come out, it's always been very poignant that they tell you who the person is, the victim. At least in pronoun. Read this article, none of that. So this motherfucker was just running around promising everybody everything. Men, women, dogs. Bitch, you want a part? Gotta suck this dick. Gotta lick this peanut butter out this booty hole. I'm just saying, I don't know. I wasn't a fly on the wall, but when people start getting a whole lot of money, shit start getting real strange. You gotta keep that kink up. So the next story we got is the queen of pop herself, Miss Jackson, if you're nasty. People been calling her petty because of something that she did, which I personally don't think was that petty. So she's doing this lineup in Glastonbury and this huge festival and the Glastonbury Festival. And there are going to be a lot of people on the lineup. You know how they'll have the lineup posters, they'll have just like 100,000 fucking names next to each other with little dots in between them, and you gotta like squint. And they'll put the bigger names at the top, and they'll get smaller and smaller, and it's, you know, the lineup is based off of like importance or whatever. And so this year, some of the people in the lineup include like Kylie Jenner, and a couple rappers, that type of thing. So Janet, when she got the flyer, her name was fifth in line behind, like, doesn't even matter who it was. That I mean, if it wasn't God, or like, you know what I'm saying? Aretha Whitney, like, who was in front of her? The Kendall Jenners and the Travis Scotts of the world. I was like, seriously? So Janet didn't make a stink, didn't make a big scene. She re-edited the photo, the flyer, or had somebody do it, and made it her name as the front name. So, you know, maybe like cut and paste type of deal, and reposted it. And people was kind of like, oh, she petty. And I'm like, bitch, shut the fuck up. Seriously. Go buy some of that cheap fucking stinking ass makeup from this bitch who is the world's youngest billionaire because your sister fucked Ray J. All right. So the last story we got tonight, I hope this mic been picking up everything because I'm not doing this shit over. If you like are a fan of comedy and comedians and any of that, you know who Lil Nail is. So I'm talking about back from like the Comedy Jam days, the Chicken Circuit, the whole shebang. Lil Nail, thick, blonde hair, talk real ignorant shit, long nails, say anything, always got on some colorful damn Mumu, 1,000 gold rings, like I love Lil Nail. Lil Nail finally is getting a Vegas residency show. And people need to start putting her in more movies. She's funny as shit. She was in this movie with Sacha Baron Cohen, the guy who does like Borat. I forgot what the movie was called. Hilarious. Like, come on, throw her in there. Don't forget, check out my girl, Sean Don T, and the new book she has out. Go get it. Hard Times, The Life of a Ghetto Black Chick. Pick it up, read some bitches. All right, so that's about it. RADARLive, number 5. Yeah, I gotta go join this dick. Don't you wanna try it? People gonna say what they're gonna say. It could be desire. Think it's a mistake that we gotta make. Cause you're almost messed up as me. And though it don't go very deep. But honey, when we're lying,